the mixing zone.
You can see it as you approach it where the outfall is hitting the water, and there's a lot of turbulence in the water. So then that's where I collected for them.
That's where wastewater treatment plants deposit treated fluids back into our river systems. And that's where researcher Morgan Sunken discovered higher levels of forever chemicals known as PFAS in Pittsburgh's three rivers.
PFAS have been associated with a variety of different cancers, different metabolic issues.
Sunken is a graduate student at the University of Michigan. She's also the author of a new study published by local nonprofit group called Women for a Healthy Environment.
And so what that's telling us is that two things. One is that the wastewater treatment plants don't have the capacity to filter out PFAS, which is a harmful chemical, a ubiquitous chemical. And the other thing that it's telling us is that, what we use and get and we wash down the drain is certainly going into our water system, into our waterways.
Allegheny County Councilwoman Michelle Nakarati-Chepkis is one of the nonprofit's leaders. She met us along the Ohio River near the Alka Sand plant, one of three locations where Sunken found higher levels of PFAS, 15.3 parts per trillion, up from fewer than four. Also in this study, the Allegheny Valley Joint Sewage Authority and the McKeesport Wastewater Treatment Plant. Some of the detections in the study were higher than the current federal limit for chemicals in drinking water.
If people are recreating on the river, for instance, and catching fish and eating those fish, that could be a source of exposure. The drinking water that we consume is a source of exposure. Actually, the drinking water is one of the major sources of PFAS exposure. And so we're seeing that when we're doing our testing here in the waterways.
PFAS are a group of human-made chemicals that resist heat, grease, and water. They're pretty much everywhere in our daily lives. And science suggests they are linked to higher risks for certain health conditions, including some cancers, low birth weight, and interference with the body's natural hormones.
Because of the ubiquitous nature of it, we should be concerned about the presence of it. And as a result of that, we are calling upon DEP at our state level to put together a policy requirement so that there's monitoring of PFAS in our drinking water, in our waterways, as well as a mechanism for reporting those.
And that was Shannon Perrine reporting. Pittsburgh's Action News 4 has reached out to all three wastewater treatment plants. Penn American Water oversees the McKeesport plant and says it supports US EPA efforts to protect the quality of drinking water. We also reached out to the Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection, and the DEP says it's planning to begin a monitoring program that would require some plants to monitor for PFAS discharges.